So good morning or good afternoon everyone. So today I talk about biomimesis hydroscaffold with a focus on biomimesis liver with the different application by the use of cell line primary human hepatocyte, but also the use of iPS cell for the differentiation in liver organoid. So for the context, HS Pharma company has been founded in 2014 and contain now 13 employees, including 5 PhD. Our office and lab is located in Loos, close to Lille in France. For historical activity, we have specialized in safety and efficacy assay in high content analysis and high content screening. We work with cosmetic, pharmaceutical, and nutraceutical industries. And in 2017, HS Pharma acquired the patent biomimesis to increase cellular model in 3D. In HS Pharma, we have access to cell culture lab, chemistry lab for the product of biomimesis, and you have access also to a platform with one Image Express Micro SLX from molecular devices, two liquid handle system, and two image micro confocal for imaging. For remind you, biomimesis is composed of hyaluronic acid, and we can add different cellular matrix compound like collagen. And with the new process, you can use this hydroscaffold for long-term culture. So biomimesis is made of native ECN compound, and the process makes this matrix stable a long time with a stiffness and a composition that can be adjusted to mimic organ or disease. We have different products by organ with biomimesis brain, biomimesis liver, or biomimesis adipose tissue. We have also biomimesis for mimic pathology. It's biomimesis oncology. As you can see, we have different compositions with the different products. And today we focus on biomimesis liver, we are composed of galactosamine, collagen 1, and collagen 4, with an elastic modulus of 0.6 kilopascal. So for the first result, we have a seeding Fg2 cell in biomimesis liver, and we can see on the first graph the proliferation of the cell after 7, 14, 21, and 28 days, by quantification of spheroid diameter with an increase of the diameter to 50 micrometer. In the second graph, it's a comparison of albumin secretion between Fg2 in 2D and Fg2 in biomimesis liver. And we have 20 to 30 times more secretion of albumin by the use of biomimesis liver. On the right, we can see the formation of canaliculi network with the staining of actin colocalized with MRP2, an important efflux transporter. Secondly, by the use of Fg2, we have modulin cholestasis. For that, and after 10 days of culture, Fg2 were treated with chlorpromazine to block efflux of activity of bicanalicule. And after 72 hours of treatment, the activity of canalicule was observed by the use of CDFDA efflux assay in green. And on the right, when we quantify CDFDA, we can see efflux of CDFDA with a low concentration of chlorpromazine at 10 micromolar, but an increase of CDFDA signal with higher concentration and show the induction of cholestase. We have also modeling steatosis characterized by lipid accumulation with amiodarone treatment. Here it's a comparison of different models: 2D model, ultra low attachment model without extracellular matrix and biomimesis. In all models, we can see an increase of lipid intensity in percentage of control, but we can also see for high concentration of amiodarone a decrease of steatosis due to the toxicity of amiodarone. In 2D, with a less effect on ultra-low attachment plate. Whereas the use of biomimesis permits to see an increase of lipid accumulation. So, biomimesis increases cell survival and enables high dose testing by the 3D cell culture and the microenvironment. And that's why we have also performed some toxicity studies to see difference between 2D and biomimesis by using a dose response of chlorpromazine and amiodarone treatment. We see that IC50 show that we have a shift of the 3D with a better cell survival at high concentration due to 3D and extracellular matrix. Here is the last result on FG2, and we have a test market drug now to induce hepatic steatosis or not in human, and we have compared the 3D model of ultra-low attachment plate and biomimesis liver. This data show a better correlation of biomimesis with in vivo data on human than ultra-low attachment model. Because primary human hepatocyte is the gold standard, we have also tested their culture in biomimesis liver. On the left, we can see a graph of the primary human hepatocyte diameter from two donors after 7 days and 14 days of cell culture. This data shows that we can keep the cellular viability to 14 days. On the right, it's a comparison of gene expression between 2D and 3D. Cytochrome 1A1, it's detoxification enzyme of phase 1. UGT1A1, it's a detoxification enzyme of phase 2. NTCP and BSCP are important transporters for bile acid. And we see that we have a better expression in biomimesis liver than in 2D. So, biomimesis liver increase cell culture time of primary human hepatocyte and also gene expression of enzyme of phase 1 and 2 and transporter gene. To finish on primary human hepatocyte, we have also tested different cytochrome activity. So, graph on the left, it's a comparison between 2D and biomimesis liver in basal condition. And graph on the right, it's the basal and induced condition of cytochrome in biomimesis liver. We can see for all cytochrome 3A4, cytochrome 1A1, and cytochrome 2B6, a better activity of cytochrome by the use of biomimesis liver. And we have also the possibility to induce these three cytochrome in 3D, as you can see on the right. So here I will present you some data. It's some data with a collaboration with l'Institut du Thorax in Nantes in France. So this work was performed among the consortium Chopin for cholesterol personalized innovation, who works on hypercholesterolemia, who are characterized by a deficiency of LDL cholesterol internalization into hepatocyte. So we know some genetic risk factor like LDL receptor, who internalize LDL cholesterol. ApoB, the main lipoprotein of LDL cholesterol, and PCSK9, who are involved in the degradation of LDL receptor. So the advantage of this consortium is that we have access to patients, and we have access to urine patients, because in Nantes they have
a protocol to isolate urine cells and reprogramming them into induced pluripotent stem cell. And we have a protocol to differentiate induced pluripotent stem cell into hepatocyte-like cell. So it's a published protocol who mimics the liver development. So we pass by different steps like definitive endoderm, hepatic progenitor, and finally at day 20, hepatocyte-like cell. So we can generate hepatocyte-like cell from urine cell after the reprogrammation and the differentiation.
So here we have used the HLC model in 2D to modeling hypercholesterolemia. So on the left, it's LDL body P internalization with HLC from control patient, but also HLC from hypercholesterolemic patient who have a mutation on PCSK9. And you can see with the signal that you have less internalization of body P into hepatocyte from hyperkalemic patient. This experiment has been confirmed by FACS cytometry. As you can see on the right, on the top, that we have less internalization of LDL body P with HLC from hyperkalemic patient. So we can reproduce the basal phenotype in vitro. But you can also reproduce the pharmacological phenotype because when you treat the cell with statin, so here is pravastatin, you can return to the basal level of control with HLC from hyperkalemic patient. So we can reproduce the phenotype of patient in vitro under basal condition and after pharmacological treatment. So this model, it's a good model for 2D monogenic liver disease like hypercholesterolemia, alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency, Wilson disease, or Nemac-Pick disease. But there are some limitations. It's not suitable for toxicological application. We have a low activity of detoxification enzyme, cytochrome P450, and because we have an immature phenotype close to a perinatal liver. It's also not suitable for complex disease like NASH for non-alcoholic steatosis hepatitis because we don't have extracellular matrix to mimic fibrosis. And we don't have also other liver cell type who are involved in NASH. So with this model in 2D, we have limitation for toxicological study, but also for modeling complex disease. The liver, it's a complex organ with different cell types like cholangiocyte, hepatocyte, Kupffer cell for immune cell, stellate cell, and sinusoidal endothelial cell. We know that there is different strategy to enhance maturation by the use of co-culture, microfluidic or the 3D culture without extracellular environment or with extracellular environment with the use of synthetic polymer, biopolymer or matrigel. For this work, we have choose to use Biomesis liver to enhance maturation of hepatocyte-like cell. But we have also choose to use a 96 well plate for future drug screening. For the differentiation of human-induced pluripotent stem cell in 3D, we have adapted the 2D protocol for the 3D environment. We have changed cytokine concentration with different gradient, and we have also added different molecule for enhance the differentiation. And as you can see on the right, on the top, it's a view of well from a 96 well plate. It's nucleus staining with DAPI. As you can see, we have a different cell cluster. And when we stain cell cluster with phalloidine to see cytoskeleton, we can see that we have a cellular organization with different cavity. And just on the right, it's a biphotonic experimentation to see, is it in blue here, to see the production of collagen 1. So we have cell cluster with cellular organization and capacity to produce collagen 1 by our liver organoid. So here it's a little movie of different Z-stack of our organoid with the staining by phalloidin to see the cytoskeleton, and you can see we have a development of a complex architecture with different cavities inside our cell cluster. We have also stained zonula occludans 1, it's a tight junction protein, to see polarization. And you can see here 5 different organoids.
So to go more deeper, we are perform transcriptomic comparison between the 2D model and the 3D model. On the left, we can see a principal component analysis between the beginning of the differentiation at day 0 and at the end of differentiation at day 20 for the 2D and at day 28 for the 3D. So you can see on the left that there are no difference at the beginning of differentiation, and on the right we can see we have a big difference between the 3D model and the 2D model. In the middle, it's a volcano plot to compare the 3D model and the 2D model at the end of differentiation. And as we can see, we have more than 7,000 genes differentially expressed. On the right, it's a heat map to compare 3D and 2D. And we can see that we have an annonce of liver specific gene expression. For example, gene for glucose metabolism, insulin metabolism, or bile metabolism. We have seen that with our transcriptomic data that we have more expression of LHX2 into our liver organoid. LHX2 is expressed by stellate cell, and that's why we are perform some immunostaining experiment. So DAPI in blue is for nucleus, albumin in green is for hepatocyte, and we can see also protein expression of desmin who are expressed by stellate cell. So we have a presence of different liver cell type. We can see also an expression of SOX9 protein in green, CFTR in red, and SOX9 and CFTR it's for cholangiocyte. We can see also that we have protein expression of CD31 in red for endothelial cell, and LHX2 in green it's for stellate cell. So here it's a staining of live one. It's for sinusoidal endothelial cell, and OATP1B1 it's a xenobiotic transporter. So we have the presence of different liver cell type. So now what are the metabolism capability of this organoid? So we have performed some experimentation of LDL fluorescence internalization. So here it's experiment of LDL body P treatment with or without statin treatment. So here it's mevastatin. Statin is a common treatment for the treatment of hypercholesterolemia. And as we can see on the right, when we treat the cell with mevastatin, we have an increase of internalization of LDL body P. So It's perhaps a good model for modeling hypercholesterolemia. We don't also know if our model is perhaps a good model for modeling NASH for non-alcoholic steatosis hepatotiasis. NASH is characterized by a lipid accumulation, an activation of cell into myofibroblast, and with the remodeling of extracellular environment.
So here it's experimentation for lipid accumulation with or without treatment with amiodarone who induce reticulum endoplasmic stress to have an increase of lipid accumulation and ethanol to increase the biosynthesis of lipid. So here in red it's the staining of by Neil Red for neutral lipid, and when we quantify the picture, we can see that we have an increase of lipid accumulation inside our organoid liver model. So we have a possible model for NASH. Because NASH it's a chronic disease, we are perform transcriptomic analysis during differentiation and at the end of differentiation at day 28, but also after 3 weeks. So here it's a principal composant analysis during differentiation, and we can see that we have the same signature of gene expression at the end of differentiation and after 3 weeks at day 49. So a possible model for NASH. Chronic disease.
We have also performed some functional tests to see cytochrome activity. So here we have treated the organoid by a specific substrate in basal condition and in induced condition. And we can see for the cytochrome 3A4 that we have a basal production but not in induced condition. But when we see the disappearance of the testosterone, we can see that we have a big decrease of testosterone after 48 hours. So perhaps we have a metabolization of the product of the testosterone. And for cytochrome 1A2, 2C9, and 2D6, we have a basal and an induced production.
To conclude, we have seen that we have an increase of albumin secretion with HBG2 by the use of biomimesis liver. We can also enhance cytochrome activity and enhance FAS1 and 2 or transporter gene expression in parahuman hepatocyte by the use of biomimesis liver. We can also modeling steatosis with the model of liver organoid or other cell line. We can also use this hydro scaffold for long-term cell culture. And finally, we can also use this hydro scaffold for the differentiation of human-induced pluripotent stem cell, like we have seen with the formation of liver organoid to enhance maturation of the differentiation. So thank you everyone. If you have any questions.